Yes, good morning students. In the previous class, we discussed on linear block code, how to get the generator matrix, if the parity check matrix is given, or the vice versa. That is, you know, generator matrix is nothing but identity matrix followed by the parity matrix. And the parity check matrix is the transpose of it. So you are going to have the parity transpose appended with the identity matrix. So this is how you generate a linear block code. So with the help of this generator matrix or parity check matrix, you can have your code check vector equations being generated, and you are going to have the corresponding code vector for the respective message signal. And now we'll see at the receiver side how you are going to decode this linear block codes. So for this, we are in need of a syndrome decoder. So here, what we are going to do is, you are going to make use of the same parity check matrix which is used at the transmitter side. And you are going to have a set of error pattern vectors being designed, which is capable of detecting the single bit error locations. So this is going to be a vector. We call it as error pattern. And you are going to have the received code word. So this is your block diagram of the syndrome decoder. So in the syndrome decoder, you have got the error pattern being generated. The error pattern is being XORed with your received code vector, each and every corresponding bit, first bit, second bit, up to nth bit. You are going to have the modulo 2 addition being performed. So your code vector, your check bit which you are going to generate, is going to be received vector R XORed with your error pattern vector. So this will result in a syndrome calculator. So what you are going to have in the syndrome calculator is, it is received vector multiplied with the parity check transpose, matrix transpose, H transpose, where H is going to be the parity check matrix. So this will result in the corresponding lookup error pattern. So that particular error pattern is going to be XORed with the received code vector. And we'll be checking the each and every corresponding bit location whenever there is a change. The change means being zero, being received, but actual transmitted pattern mean is going to be one, means then you can identify the location where the error has occurred and you can correct it. Okay. So what is it? So it is going to be a non-zero output of the product R into H transpose. It is called as a syndrome and it is denoted as S. So only you are going to have a non-zero pattern. It is going to be S. You don't have any zero component in it, which is denoted as S, which is the syndrome, which is the received code vector R into H transpose. And this has got set of properties. So as I said, R is the received data, H transpose is the transpose of your parity check matrix. And the dimension of this syndrome is going to be a row matrix, 1 cross N minus K. Okay, N is going to be the block length and K is the number of message bits. This we already have seen in the linear beginning of the linear block code. And the first property of this syndrome decoder is S is equal to RH transpose is your syndrome vector. And it depends only on the error pattern and not on the code word. So this is the first property. There is no relation between the code word and the syndrome vector which you are going to have. It is only depending upon the error pattern. So S is equal to R into H transpose, where R, the received code vector, is C XORed with your error pattern. Or S is, in place of R, substitute C XORed with E. So you have to substitute here and H transpose is over here. And as usual, you go for commutative distributive law. It is C into H transpose XORed with E into H transpose. On a whole, the resultant is E into H transpose. The second property is, all the error pattern that differs by the code word have same syndrome. So the syndrome will be common for all the error pattern, which is going to be differ from the code vector. So to implement this, you are going to have a set of algorithm to be followed, which is called as decoding algorithm. So for this to happen, the first step is you have to compute the parity check matrix. H matrix is P transpose appended with I. So for this to happen, you should have your generated matrix G, which is I appended with P. From that, you take the P value, take the P transpose of it, and you can have your H. Get the received vector R. So whatever vector you are going to receive at the receiver end, you get that. Compute the syndrome for it. So the syndrome is R and your H transpose. You will be having H from this matrix. Get the transpose of that H and do the normal matrix multiplication. Then construct the decoding table. So locate the error pattern E corresponding to the syndrome for the referring decode. Table. So you construct a decoding table, append the syndrome for the corresponding decoding table. Wherever you are going to have the error pattern, you just match with the syndrome, corresponding syndrome with the decoding table content, and add this error with the received vector to correct the error. So this is going to be the decoding algorithm, which is going to be the second property of your syndrome vector. To easily understand how you can construct this syndrome vector is, can have this problem. So you are going to have a generator matrix, which is 6, 3, which says code vector is 6, message symbol in it is 3, systematic block code is given. So G is given. It is going to have identity matrix appended with the P matrix, P sub matrix. Okay. So for this to happen, first you should note what is H. Then you have to prepare the decoding table. Then you have to consider what is H transpose. Then you have to compute the syndrome S value. Then construct the decoding table. Note the corresponding error pattern. Then you can get the error, where the error has occurred, and you can correct that error also. So for this, you are going to have the received sequence as 101, 101. So your code vector is 6. It is 6, 3. So code vector should be having 6 bits in the matrix. So take a received code vector. You can assume any bit pattern. And you are going to identify what is actually transmitted. This was the received sequence. And you have to find where the error has occurred, whether the error has occurred or not. If error has occurred, in which location it has occurred. And you have to correct it. So for that, we have to find the message. So from the given generator matrix, compute your H matrix. H is P transpose appended with I. And this is going to be the P. Get the P value from the G matrix. Write it down here. Get the P transpose. Just place your row and the column elements. Interchange it and get the P transpose. So H is P transpose appended with I. So this is your P transpose. You can write the P transpose and your identity matrix. So this is going to be the H. For calculating the syndrome, you need H transpose. So just change your row and the column elements. So your 3 × 6 will become 6 × 3. So this is going to be the H transpose. So this is your first step to get the H transpose from the given generator matrix. Next is write your received code vector R, which is given in the problem statement. Then compute the syndrome. Syndrome is R into H transpose. So this is your R value and this is your H transpose value. Multiply this. So take the row elements, multiply with the first column element, which will give you the first element in the syndrome vector. Received vector multiplied with the second column elements will give you the second element in the syndrome. Then multiplying the received vector with the third column element in the H transpose will give you the third element. Just your normal multiplication, you can see 1 into 1. So 1 is 1. 0 into 1 is 0. 1 into 0 is 0. 1 into 1 is 1. 0 into 0 is 0, 1 into 0 is 0. So what you have to do is you have to go for modulo 2 addition. It's not your normal addition while you do your matrix. So normal multiplication has to be performed within the row and the column elements, but you have to do the modulo 2 addition. Similarly, the received elements with the second column elements will give you all these 6 product terms, and this is with the multiplying with the last third column. And here, since it is an XOR operation, for odd number of ones you'll be having 1, for even number of ones it is 0. So here only 2 ones are here, 0, because XOR is both the inputs to be the same, output is 0. Any one of the input to be high, it is going to be 1, you know where. So this is 1 1, it is 0. Here you have got 3 ones in the sequence, so it's an odd number of 1, so it is 1. Now you have to construct the decoding table. So decoding table you can construct by forming the error pattern. So error pattern is, it is going to be a pattern of symbols, that is, error may occur at the first bit position or in the second bit position or third bit position. Here there are 6 bits in the code vector, so your error pattern should be from E1 to E6. So just form a table with E1 to E6. And the syndrome is S is S0, S1 and S3. It is 3 bit only. So because it has H transpose has got 3 columns, so you'll be having 3 bits in it. Okay. So here, if the first bit is 1, you can take it as all high, 1, 1, 1. If the second bit is 1, just you write the reverse of your normal binary sequence. For say n is equal to 3, 2 to the power of 3, 8 combinations. Okay. So for the 8 combinations, it is 0, 0, 0 to 1, 1, 1. So here you do it in the reverse side. First bit to be 1, it is all 1. Second bit to be becoming an error, it is 1, 1, 0. Third bit, it is 0, 1, 1. That is 7, 6, 5, 4, 2, 3, 2, 1. Like that, you can write your syndrome vector. So here, for this pattern 001, where is 001 occurring? 001 occurs in this table in the last row. The error pattern for this is 5 zeros followed by 1. So this is what you have to map. What is a syndrome vector? From the table, for the syndrome vector, identify what is the error pattern. So this is going to be the error pattern for the syndrome of 001. You have got 001 here. So 001 is 5 zeros followed by 1. So how to calculate the corrected? So the received vector C is equal to E plus R. This is your error pattern and this is your received vector. You just do the XOR operation. 1, 1 is 0, 0, 0 is 0, 0, 1 is 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0 is 1, 0, 1 is 1. Just you perform XOR addition between the E and the R component. So this is going to be the decoded vector. 101, 101, 100. So the first 3 bit is going to be the message bit and the last 3 bit is the parity bit. So this is how you find the message bit from the given generator matrix. Thank you.